Hello everyone! I'm so excited because in front of me, as you can see, it's a chic sparrow, and I just jumped right into putting you guys facing down. I couldn't handle like doing an intro or anything. I just want to get right into this. It showed up today. I ordered this on Sunday. Today is Wednesday and it showed up in my mailbox today. I'm so impressed with their shipping. It's amazing. You can track your shipping. I really, really enjoy that process. And so going in here, I'm just gonna pull it out and then pull out my little like billing thing. Ooh, and there looks like there's an extra goodie in here. I did not order that. It came in extra, it looks like. Very cool. It looks like it's a pen pouch. How cool is that? I have noticed on the Chic Sparrow Facebook group that Jennifer Harvey's been kind of like throwing in like the key fobs. And so she's been throwing in some extra goodies, which is awesome. Oh, it smells so good. This is really beautiful. So thank you for sending that little extra goodie in there. That's really nice to see that. And what I ordered, you probably saw the title already, so you know what I ordered. But I could not order this, okay? So, the reason why, I'm gonna put that down because it's noisy. Now, this is the Mr. Darcy. I see so many people talking about Mr. Darcy. It's such a popular video that shows up in my subscription feed. And I have tried to resist because I keep telling myself I don't need any more, but I just cannot help myself. Like I just couldn't. I couldn't help myself any longer. Now, I really wanted the, I think it's the buttered rum one, which is kind of a little bit on the lighter side, but then, you know what? I have so many of that really beautiful kind of lighter brown, that honey colored traveler's notebooks. I have so many of those that I thought I don't have anything that is this beautiful kind of burgundy color. I don't have anything in this kind of color. And I just really want to get my hands on it. I wanted to know why everyone is so excited by this traveler's notebook. I really am just curious. I want to know why everyone is so into this. So I purchased, this is again, the Mr. Darcy Classic in wide burgundy with white top stitching. So it comes with, I've noticed that the elastics come out of the spines, which I have a couple of them right next to me here, and I have a creme brulee where there was originally, looks like, in the back. But I think most traveling company people who make these traveler's notebooks now have realized that it's better coming out of the spine versus on the back, because it kind of tends to get in the way when you're writing. So this is very, very lightweight, being that it is classic. It's not the deluxe, so it doesn't have all the pockets and things like that inside. I didn't get the deluxe, A, for like cost purposes. I wanted to save on some of the costs of that. And then I don't always utilize the pockets. I'll be totally honest with you folks. So this is what it looks like inside. I love the simplicity of this. I love how kind of clean it is. And I'm just so surprised at how lightweight this leather is. I thought it was gonna be very heavy. I can imagine that probably the deluxe is a bit heavier because you've got all the pockets kind of weighing it down. But this is a really nice lightweight leather. And it is extremely, extremely smooth. Really beautiful chocolate colored elastics. I love Jennifer Harvey's elastics. I think they're great. The stitching is really nice in here. It feels a little raw. I'm going to say that, like, we're in the sense that it's not like the super clean where you would see in the deluxe, but that's because the deluxe is going up against another piece of leather. So it looks kind of really clean in that regard, and that's what I mean. I'm not saying that it's like dirty physically. I'm saying that it doesn't have that like pristine kind of look because you don't have the leather in here with the, like you do with the deluxe. So I'm just making that statement. I'm not saying anything negative. It's just not as clean because it's a single piece of leather. So this inside is relatively smooth. There are some things that kind of catch on my hand, and it's just a very smooth leather. From what I've seen, is a lot of folks tend to roll this and it gives it kind of like a wrinkly appearance. I'm not going to do that. I don't care for that kind of a look. I already kind of see some striations here in the leather that are really going to kind of probably pop out the more that I use this traveler's notebook. But just to kind of give you all an idea of the color, it is a very beautiful, it almost reminds me of like a mahogany kind of color. There's definitely, I'm trying to see in the camera, in the viewfinder, what you are all seeing, but it looks more brown in the viewfinder, but it's definitely got a lot of the cherry wood kind of appearance to it. And there is a lot of kind of striations. So for those folks who are like on the fence about rolling this, what's going to happen is like all these little kind of like streaks and things that are coming, you're going to really, that's going to be very pronounced in there. And I've seen some folks very uncomfortable with that because it becomes like very, very pronounced. So I will not roll it. I don't mind about like the scratches and the dings. I do see some scratches on here. But again, that's the story that the notebook kind of tells, which I really love. It's a beautiful piece of leather, very lightweight. I'm just so impressed with how lightweight it is. And I have the American, this is an American Dream from that really like hot pink. I think it was like Peabody maybe the color. I forget what the name of it was. Don't quote me on that. But this is a very, very, very like smooth and shiny kind of a leather. So I just want to kind of see what that looked like compared to Mr. Darcy. Mr. Darcy is totally different. Like he has a different kind of shine. I don't know what he'll feel like once kind of the wear on him goes there, but it's a different feeling from this leather here. But if I were to roll this leather, it would be very wrinkly as well. But look, it feels very different from that American Dream. This was the creme brulee that I got several years back, and this leather is just like oiled. It feels heavy. It feels wet and heavy. If that's the, it's not wet, okay, but it just feels that way. It feels very kind of moist and heavy. This feels a lot drier and a lot kind of like thinner and not nearly as heavy as the creme brulee. Like the creme brulee has some serious weight to it. This is very lightweight. And then I also have the, this is, I think, Gemini 2.0. And I want to say it was Leaf. can't remember. I know Jennifer came out with a green color for this year, for this spring. But I love this. I think it's really pretty. I have some inserts in here because I've been using it kind of for the springtime. But like I said, I just kind of had to get my hands on the Mr. Darcy. I'm just so curious as to why everybody is really enjoying this leather. Now, this leather feels very kind of dry, like someone who has tired old skin, kind of, not a great way of being able to describe that. But I still love it very much. It just doesn't feel very luxurious in the hand, I guess is what I'm gonna say. It feels just kind of dry. It's still a really nice piece of leather, and I love how bright it is, but you can just hear how like it's just very dry. It's a very dry kind of feeling. It has I would say just maybe a little bit more weight than the Mr. Darcy does, but the Mr. Darcy, I'm just so impressed with how lightweight it is. And it just could be because all those other ones are deluxe besides the creme brulee. I think the creme brulee is not a deluxe and doesn't even have stitching on it, but the other two are deluxe, so maybe they have a little bit more weight to them and that's why. But I'm just very impressed with how lightweight this is. I'm looking forward to seeing how this wears with all the scratches. I'm very impressed. I'm going to start using this right away, and I will have some feedback for you, and I'm just dying to know what all the craze is about. So if you have one, please share in the comments why you love yours, and make sure you check out my Instagram because it'll probably be popping up there a fair bit. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon. Take care.